Hello students, welcome to second video lecture on multiple choice questions in thermodynamics and statistical mechanics. In this video lecture, I am going to discuss multiple choice questions on second chapter, that is Maxwell's relations and their applications. Let us see brief summary of this. Now, state of system. State of system. The state of system means the particular condition of a thermodynamic system described by measurable quantities like pressure, temperature, volume, entropy of a system. Next, internal energy. The sum of internal energy and internal potential energy and internal kinetic energy is called as internal energy. Now, this internal energy depends on temperature only. The first law of thermodynamics states that when amount of heat dQ is supplied to the system, partly it goes to change in internal energy and remaining goes to do the external work. So dQ is equal to dU plus pdV. According to second law of thermodynamics, dQ is equal to T into dS. So if we use this here, we get dU is equal to TdS minus PdV. dU is change in internal energy. Now we have number of thermodynamic functions. The properties of a pure substance are conveniently expressed in terms of thermodynamic functions. Thermodynamic functions or potentials are, first one is internal energy, we denote it by U. Helmholtz free energy, we denote by F, it is equal to U minus TS, where T is absolute temperature and S is entropy of the system. Third one, that is enthalpy, H is equal to U plus PV, where P is pressure and V is volume of the system. Next one is Gibbs function, G is equal to U plus PV minus TS. And their differentials, change in internal energy, enthalpy, Helmholtz free energy or Gibbs function. So here dU is equal to TdS minus PdV. We have seen here dU is equal to TdS minus PdV. This one. Now second one is dF. dF we know U minus TS. So dF we can write dU minus TdS minus SdT. Now dU minus TdS, it is equal to minus PD. So we get here dF is equal to minus PdV minus SdT. Similarly dH. So dH is equal to dU plus PdV plus VdP. But this one is TdS. So we get dH is equal to TdS plus VdP. Similarly, we can find dG. dG is equal to, from this, dU plus PdV plus VdP minus TdS minus SdT. Here we have five variables. Now, dU plus PdV, it is TdS, so we can write TdS plus VdP minus TdS minus SdT. So these two will cancel, so dG is equal to VdP minus SdT. Now we will go to Maxwell's thermodynamic relations. We know total differential. So suppose we have function f, mathematical function f, that is function of two variables x, y, then its total differential dF is given as m into dx plus n into dy, where m and n may be functions of x and y. So this dF is said to be exact when it satisfies this condition. So here we take m and its partial derivative with respect to y. M with respect to y, keeping x constant. we take n and its partial derivative with respect to x, keeping y constant. If these two are equal, then df is said to be exact differential. But if they are not equal, df is not exact differential. Now here, du, df, dh, and dg, these are exact differential equations, differentials. So we can find some relations using this condition, dabba m by dabba y is equal to dabba n by dabba x. So if we take this first one, du is equal to tds minus pdv, from this we get first one, that is dabba t by dabba v at constant s is equal to minus dabba p by dabba s at constant v. Second, we get from df, that is dabba s by dabba v at constant t is equal to dabba p by dabba t at constant v. Third one, we get from dh, dabba t by dabba p at constant s is equal to dabba v by dabba s at constant p. This is third relation. Then dabba v by dabba t at constant p is equal to minus dabba s by dabba p at constant t. This is obtained from dg. This is fourth equation. These are called Maxwell's relations in thermodynamics. We have another relations in thermodynamics also. That is first TdS equation. Using above conditions, we can find TdS equations. We are interested here in mathematical forms only. So here TdS is equal to CV dt plus T into dabba P by dabba T at constant V into dV. This is called first TdS equation, where CV is equal to T into dabba S by dabba T at constant V. CV, it is called specific heat. It is called specific heat at constant V, constant volume. Second TdS equation is TdS is equal to Cp dt minus T into dabba V by dabba T at constant P into dP, where Cp, that is specific heat at constant pressure, is T into dabba S by dabba T at constant P. And we have here for ideal gas Cp minus Cv, this is Mayer's relation, this is equal to R. And for van der Waals gas, we know van der Waals equation of state, P plus A by V square multiplied by V minus P is equal to RT. This is van der Waals equation of state. For this equation of state, we get Cp minus Cv is equal to R in bracket 1 plus 2A upon V RT. Now, latent heat equation is given as dP by dT is equal to L upon T V2 minus V1, where L is latent heat. Joule-Thomson effect. When a gas under pressure is allowed to pass through a porous plug to a region of low pressure, its temperature is lower, which is known as Joule-Thomson effect. Means, suppose we take simple example. Suppose we have a system, here small throttle, and in this system we have gas, and using piston, suppose we compress this gas, so it is at high pressure, this gas will pass through this throttle and it will expand. Here it is low pressure region, so what happens, temperature of the gas decreases, and this is called Joule-Thomson effect. Now temperature of inversion, the temperature at which Joule-Thomson effect is zero, that temperature and changes its sign is known as temperature of inversion, and that is given as Ti is equal to 2A upon RB for real gas. Boyle's temperature dV, Boyle's temperature is that temperature at which the product PV remains constant, and dV is equal to A upon RB, where A and B are van der Waals constant, and Ti, it is 2 times TV if we compare these two equations. So this is some short summary. Now let us go to multiple choice questions. Now first question, The first law of thermodynamics is presented in terms of heat absorbed dq, change in internal energy du, pressure p and change in volume dv by the relation. Now first law of thermodynamics we know dq is equal to du plus p dv, where du is internal change in internal energy, dq is heat supplied and PdV is work done. So if we see in these equations, first one is incorrect. Here PdV, so this is incorrect. PdV is equal to dq plus du, this is also incorrect. So dq is equal to du plus PdV, this is correct one. Now the first, next one, the first law of thermodynamics is restatement of the thermodynamic equilibrium, law of heat addition, conservation of energy, total heat content of the system. First law of thermodynamics, it is related to conservation of energy. Conservation of energy. So here, this third one is correct. Now, internal energy of system, U is expressed in terms of temperature T, entropy S, pressure P and volume V by the following relation. So we know dq is equal to du plus PdV. So du is equal to dq minus PdV. But according to second law of thermodynamics, dq is T into dS minus P into dV. So du is equal to this. So if we take here, first one is incorrect, second one is incorrect, third one is correct, last one is incorrect. Now next one, the change in internal energy du becomes equal to work done by the system during isothermal process, isochoric process, isobaric process, adiabatic process. Isothermal process, that is at constant temperature. Isochoric process, that is at constant volume. And isobaric process, that is at constant pressure. And adiabatic process, in this process no heat is supplied to the system. So dq is equal to 0. Now we know du is equal to dq minus pdv. So when dq is equal to 0, we get what? Du is equal to minus pdv. So internal energy is used for the work done. So this is in adiabatic process, because for adiabatic process dq is equal to 0, no heat supplied to the system. In which of the following processes the internal energy of the system remains constant? Now we know du is equal to dq minus pdv. Now, if this is 0, means du is 0, means u is constant. Constant. Now, du is 0, means dq is 0, dv is 0. These are differential parameters. dq is 0 means dq is 0 means adiabatic process. And dv is 0 means isochoric process. So here, adiabatic and isochoric, this first one is correct. Now, isothermal process takes place at constant volume, pressure, temperature, heat transfer. So it is at constant temperature. So heat is supplied to the system, work is done, but temperature of the system remains constant. That is called isothermal process. Isochoric process takes place at constant volume, pressure, temperature, heat transfer. So it is at constant volume. So no work done is there. Total heat content of the system is expressed in terms of. So whatever total heat, we have four enthalpy, internal energy, Helmholtz free energy, Gibbs free energy. These are four thermodynamic potentials. Out of this enthalpy is related to total heat content of the system. So enthalpy here, it is correct. Now Helmholtz free energy F is given by the equation. So what is Helmholtz free energy? Helmholtz free energy F is equal to, it is U minus TS. U minus TS. So here last one is correct. Now 11th one. Helmholtz free energy of the system DF in reversible isothermal process is equal to. Now we know Helmholtz free energy F is equal to U minus TS. So DF is equal to DU minus TDS minus SDT. Now TDS minus DU minus TDS. What is DU minus TDS? It comes out to be minus PdV minus SDT. This is DF. So isothermal process means dT is equal to zero. No change in temperature. Temperature T is constant. So what happens here? dT is equal to zero, so we'll get dF is equal to minus P dV. So this one is correct. First one is correct. Now Helmholtz free energy remains constant during following thermodynamic process. So we have here dF is equal to what? Minus PdV minus SdT. So it is constant means F is constant means dF is equal to zero. So dF is equal to zero means dV is equal to zero and dT is equal to zero. These are differential parameters. dV is equal to zero means isochoric. dT is equal to zero means isothermal. So isochoric and isothermal. So if we see here isochoric and isothermal. So last one is correct. Here isochoric adiabatic, isobaric, isothermal, isothermal adiabatic. These are incorrect one. Now enthalpy of the system H remains constant during the reversible thermodynamic process. Now we know enthalpy of the system. H is equal to U plus PV. So here dH is equal to du plus pdv plus vdp. Now du plus pdv, it is dh is equal to tds plus vdp. So here dq, so this one is 0, this one is 0 means dp is 0, dh will be 0 and h will be constant. So tds is equal to 0 means this is adiabatic. dP is equal to 0 means this is isobaric at constant pressure. So adiabatic and isobaric. So here isobaric and adiabatic. So this second one is correct. Isochoric, isobaric, no. Isothermal, adiabatic, no. Isochoric, isothermal, no. So here isobaric and adiabatic. Gibbs, next one, Gibbs free energy of a system G in thermodynamic process is given by the equation. Now what is G? So G is equal to, we know, it is U plus PV minus TS. So U plus PV minus TS. So this one is correct, this is incorrect. This is incorrect, this is incorrect. So first one is correct. Now 15th. Using thermodynamic potential internal energy U, the Maxwell thermodynamic relation is written as. Now we know dQ is equal to dU plus PdV. So we write here dq is equal to what? T ds is equal to du plus p dv. So du is equal to t ds minus p dv. So now this is total differential. So take t, differentiate it with respect to what? V at constant s. So dabba t by dabba v at constant s. Now take here minus p. So minus p and differentiate it with respect to s. So dabba p by dabba s with minus sign at constant v. If these two are equal, then du is exact differential and this equation is first thermodynamic relation. So dabba t by dabba v at constant s will be equal to minus dabba t by dabba p by dabba s at constant v. So dabba t by, so search for that. So first one, no. Second one, no. Third one, dabba t by dabba v at constant s will be equal to minus dabba p by dabba s at constant v. This one is correct and this one is also not correct. Now next one, using thermodynamic potential enthalpy H, the Maxwell's thermodynamic relation is written as, and we know H and dH. What is H? H is equal to U plus PV, and from this we get dH is equal to TdS plus VdP. Now let us take T, differentiate with respect to P at constant S. So dabba T by dabba P at constant S. Then take V and differentiate this V with S at constant P. If these two are equal, then dH is exact and this equation is called Maxwell's relation. So search for this. Dabba T by dabba P at constant S. Dabba P by dabba T at constant S. And dabba V by dabba S at constant P. So this last one is correct. This is incorrect. This is incorrect. This is incorrect. So here last one is correct. Now next one. Using the thermodynamic potential Helmholtz free energy F, the Maxwell's thermodynamic relation is written as. Now we know dF is equal to minus PdV minus SdT. So take this minus P and differentiate with respect to T. So minus dabba P by dabba T, but at constant volume. And then minus S, minus dabba S by dabba V and at constant T. And when these two are equal, dF is exact. Now you can take minus minus sign here, plus. So dabba P by dabba T at constant V is equal to dabba S by dabba V at constant T. So search here, dabba S by dabba V at constant T is equal to dabba P by dabba T at constant V. So this one is correct. Now dabba S by dabba V at constant P, no. Dabba S by dabba V at constant P, no. Dabba V by dabba S at constant T, no. So this first one is correct. Now we'll go to next one. Using thermodynamic potential Gibbs free energy G, the Maxwell's thermodynamic relation is written as. Now here we know G is equal to जी इज इक्वल टू, वी हैव जस्ट सीन हियर, जी इज इक्वल टू यू प्लस पी वी माइनस टी एस, यू प्लस यू प्लस पी वी माइनस टी एस टी एस, एंड इफ वी ऑब्टेन डी जी वी विल गेट डी जी इज इक्वल टू वी डी पी माइनस एस डी टी. नाउ हियर वी डिफ्रेंशिएट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू टी एट कॉन्स्टेंट पी, सो डाबा वी बाय डाबा टी एट कॉन्स्टेंट पी एंड देन माइनस एस, डिफ्रेंशिएट इट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू पी एट कॉन्स्टेंट टी, सो वील गेट माइनस dabba s by dabba p at constant t, and if these two are equal we get thermodynamic relation. So dabba v by dabba t at constant p is equal to minus dabba s by dabba p at constant t. So out of these three, this is incorrect, this one is correct, this is incorrect, this is also incorrect, so b is correct. Now the specific heat at constant volume is given as Cv is equal to T into dabba S by dabba T at constant V. So this third one is correct. Cv is equal to T into dabba S by dabba T at constant V. Specific heat at constant pressure is, now Cp is equal to, we want here P not V. Everywhere take P. So Cp is T into dabba S by dabba T at constant P. So third one is correct. Now the first TdS equation is given as. Now first TdS equation is TdS is equal to Cv dT plus T into dabba P by dabba T at constant V into dV. This is first TdS equation. So out of these, so first one is incorrect, second one is incorrect because here we have Cp, third one, this is correct, here we have Cp, so this is incorrect. So third one is correct. Now the second TdS equation is given as, now second TdS equation we have TdS is equal to, this is at constant pressure, so TdS is equal to, we have Cp dT minus T into dabba V by dabba T at constant P into V. So search here, here Cv, so this is incorrect. TdS is equal to Cp dT minus T dabba V by dabba T at constant P into dP. So this one is correct. Here we have Cv, so this is incorrect. This is also incorrect. Now next one, the difference between two specific heats Cp minus Cv for ideal gas is equal to, this is Mayer's relation, Cp minus Cv is equal to R. So Cp minus Cv is equal to R. So third one is correct. That is R. Now difference between two specific heats Cp minus Cv for van der Waals gas is equal to. Now that is equal to Cp minus Cv for van der Waals gas. It is R in bracket 1 plus 2A upon VRT. This is the equation. Here we use P plus A by V square into V minus B is equal to RT. This is van der Waals equation of state. So here third one is correct. Now which one of the following is conserved during in Joule-Thomson effect? गिब्स फ्री एनर्जी, हेल्महोल्ट्ज फ्री एनर्जी, इंटरनल एनर्जी, एंथैल्पी. सो इन H is equal to U plus PV, and in Joule-Thomson effect, enthalpy is conserved. So last one is correct. So enthalpy is conserved in Joule-Thomson effect. Now next one, Joule-Thomson coefficient is defined as. Now Joule-Thomson coefficient, it is given as mu is equal to dabba T by dabba P. And we know enthalpy is constant, so it is at constant H. So this is called Joule-Thomson coefficient. So if we go here, mu is equal to dabba T by dabba V at constant G, it is incorrect. Mu is equal to dabba T by dabba P at constant F, this is also incorrect. Mu is equal to dabba T by dabba P at constant H, this is correct. And mu is equal to dabba P by dabba T at constant U, this is incorrect. So second one is correct. Now Joule-Thomson coefficient is, means if we use here this equation at constant H, we get relation mu is equal to 1 upon Cp, mu is equal to 1 upon Cp into T dabba V by dabba T at constant P minus V. So you have to keep in mind this equation. So here first one is correct. Now what will be the change, next one, what will be the change in entropy of ice when 1 kilocalorie heat is supplied to convert it into water at 0 degree Celsius. Means we have ice here. Ice, that ice is converted into water when we supply heat dQ. But temperature remains constant, and that is 0 degree Celsius. So we know dQ is equal to dU plus, dQ is equal to TdS. Now dS is change in entropy, dQ is heat supplied. Now heat supplied is 1 kilocalorie, temperature is 0 degree, so I can take T is equal to 0 plus 273, that is 273 degree Kelvin. So what is dS? So dS will be equal to, now dQ upon T. So dS will be equal to 1 kilocalorie divided by 273. So if we see here, 1 upon 273 kilocalorie, here kilocalorie per degree Kelvin, but you will not get this value. So we can take this kilocalorie in calories, 1000 by 273 calories per degree Kelvin, and then calculate, we'll get this as 3.66 calories per degree Kelvin. So here this one is correct, this one is correct. Now calculate the amount of work done for expansion of the gas if total heat given to the system is 5 calorie and increase in internal energy is 340 calorie. Now we know dQ is equal to dU plus dW. dW is PdV, work done. So dW, amount of work done, is dQ minus dU. Now dQ, heat supplied, that is 500 calorie, minus increase in internal energy, that is 340 calorie. So if we take subtraction of this, we will get 160 calorie. So this much work is done, and you can convert it into joules also. But here it is given in calories. So this third one is correct. An ideal gas absorbs 2000 kilocalorie heat. 2000 kilocalorie heat and does an amount of work of 16,800 joules during the expansion. What is the increase in its internal energy? So here heat absorbed is given, and we know dQ is equal to dU plus dW or PdV. This is equal to PdV. Now dQ is given. dQ is 2000 kilocalorie. And what is work done? dW is given. That is 16,800 joules. Now see here, units are not same, so we have to convert these joules into calories or kilocalories, and we have here constant J, that is 4200 joules per kilocalorie. So dW is equal to 16,800 divided by 4200, we will get this in kilos calorie. So dW get here 4 kilocalorie. So now dW is 4 kilocalorie. So what is increase in internal energy? So here dU is equal to dQ minus dW. So here 2000 minus 4. So we'll get 1996 kilocalorie. Kilocalorie. So here 1996 kilocalorie. This one is correct. Here it is calorie. Calorie, kilocalorie, calorie, but this one is correct. So this is about some multiple choice questions on Maxwell's relations and their applications. We have to keep in mind our thermodynamic functions, their relations. Now from that you can obtain Maxwell's relations and so on. So thank you very much for this lecture. If you like my lecture, I request you to subscribe PSTAG Media by pressing subscribe button and also press like button, and also press bell icon to get notification of new lectures. Now in next lecture I will see I will explain multiple choice questions on statistical mechanics. Thanks very much.